bring everything but the hog out. Think we eat nothing but grass, what you talking about? I'm about to jump into the whip and hit the Whole Foods early. Get everything to get that soul food working, like mac and cheese, the collard greens, the black eyed peas, and get a roast of that tofu turkey. Got cornbread, even got stuff. Mashed potatoes so good, put your hands in it. Green beans, and you know we got yams with it.
Welcome back, guys. All you beautiful souls spreading compassion and the tofu cube of truth all over the world. Today I'm doing my usual little Sunday morning routine. I'm actually down here at the beach at Irvine in Ayrshire where I live. It's absolutely, it just rejuvenates the soul. You come down here and it's so, so peaceful. You see the lovely scenery. Just look at it around here, guys. It's absolutely amazing. So, I don't know if you can see it in the background there. This up here, just right there, this is the top of the where the beach is. You've got the big massive dragon type statue that they have here. So I'm going to take you up to the top of that. We're just going to get a little chat. Like I say, I love coming down here. Some days it just, it's like I say, it's just good for the soul. Doing a little bit for yourself, a bit of self-care, because getting out into nature, that's what it's all about, guys. Like I say, we've got a lovely, lovely world that we live in and we're destroying it piece by piece. Like I say, the scientists are actually telling us that we've got like 12 years, possibly, to actually save the world. And by doing so, the biggest part of that is by the choices we make 3 times a day, which is by our fork and knife. So if we can do something about that, we'll really make a big impact. And like I say, basically everything comes down to animal agriculture. Let's say the methane that comes from the animals, that's even worse than the CO2, guys, because CO2, as we know, they always blame transport, but round about anything between 18-50% actually comes from animal agriculture. So that's more than all transportation forms such as air, sea and land. So you know what I mean, things like the animals pooing and farting and burping, this is where it all comes from. So we've got to realise that we can save the planet, but we're all good people and we need to understand that we're just not living by our morals. Like I say, we love animals, we don't want to cause suffering, yet we're doing that every single day by the choices that we make, because we think that one set of animals are no more than food, and yet another set, such as dogs and cats, are companion animals. Yet they all want to live, they're all sentient beings, they all feel pain, guys. They've all got families, they all have emotions, they can be happy, they can be sad. You just know it when you go and leave your dog, when it feels, when it stands up at the window and it's crying when you go away. That's the same the way a cow, a pig, a chicken feels when the animal, the so-called owners, shall we say, that are supposed to look after them, the farmers, actually send them to slaughter. Because you see, some of these farmers, they do actually really, really care about the animals, yet they don't understand what they're actually doing. They're slaughtering the animals. Is that, they say they look after them, is that not the biggest hypocrisy you possibly can? Do you know, think that's the biggest injustice you can do that animal if you really love it? So I'm going to show you this, guys. Just look at this. Check this out. It's maybe a bit windy, but this is a big statue up here. Just look at it. You've got the big dragon here. It's amazing. So you're right at the top here. Check this out. Look at the sea. All the way along the shore. Isn't it absolutely amazing? This is the beauty we actually have. Just look at the waves coming in. Absolutely amazing, guys, it really, really is. So here's the guy here, see him? Yeah, what should we call him? Dave the Dragon? Tofu Tommy's mate. So yeah, absolutely lovely. I'm just going to get a little bit of meditation done here. I do this quite often, guys. This is my little getaway sometimes, just when I need a bit of time to myself, just to rejuvenate the soul. Because when you're a vegan activist especially, you've got to look after yourself. Self-care comes first, because like I say, you can't look after the animals until you look after yourself and be the best you possibly can. So I'm going to get a little bit of meditation done, guys, and probably during this video I may show you some of my gym workouts as well. I think that'd be quite good for you to let you see how I'm progressing. So I'll speak to you all soon, guys, and much love as always.
Got my ass squeezed by sexy Cupid. Cause he wants to play, wants to play. I love game, I love game.
Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm actually down at the processing plant here at Robertson's in Irvine, which is actually the slaughterhouse that we usually go to in Ardrossan, but this is a new processing plant that they've just been given millions of pounds by the Scottish Government Enterprise Scheme to actually process these animals into products, as they call them. So as you can see here, just look at that, guys. You can actually see it. The gates are actually closed. You've actually got to get special entrance to actually get into the place. So they're actually covering the place up. So it just shows you that they're guilty of what they actually, they know what they're doing. So it's disgusting, guys, it really, really is. But anyway, we've got a video on Wednesday. We're going back to this place in Ardrossan in Ayrshire. So this place down here in Irvine is only a few minutes down the road from where I actually live. So I just come down here to check it out and see what they're actually doing down here. But like I say, you can't even get in the gates. There's no access to it unless you're obviously coming here to deliver or pick up their products, as they call them. But I wanted to talk to you a little about my feelings on the vegan community at the moment. I'm just kind of disgusted with things because I feel as if I'm getting pulled further away from certain vegans, and especially those that think that they're above certain people. Like I say, I can understand why people actually pull away from the vegan movement quite a bit and do their own type of activism out with these brandings and such likes, because it seems to me that a lot of people are just taking what they can out of veganism and what it does for them rather than the animals. Like I say, what benefit they can get, social media standing, and what you can pay them monthly. And it's getting to the point, it's all about hierarchy. And like I say, people that are obviously innovative and obviously want to give ideas out, they're shut down right away. And it seems to be all about these big groups and how big you are, rather than supporting people who are actually in it for the animals. And it's pushing people away, guys. And I just feel that it's really curbing a lot of people's enthusiasm, because it's not about you, it's not about me, it's about the animals. And we should all be in it to support each other. And if we don't do that, it's only us that's going to derail the vegan movement. Like I say, at the end of the day, the vegan scene is growing massively in virtually most countries at the moment. So the only thing that's going to stop the vegan movement from growing is the people within it, because the meat dairy industries, they're all on their knees, they know it, and they're using every single tactic in this world basically to try and get the public to go back to buying their products, or what they believe is products, because they want us to believe that they're just products, because at the end of the day, that's a euphemism, guys. It's anything to have you basically kept in that cognitive dissonance, making you think that these animals are just products. They don't want you to make the connection to what the actual animal out in the farming field actually is. They don't want you to get that, because at the end of the day, if you do, you'll be disgusted by it, because I believe that we're all animal lovers, we're all good people. It's just we're brought up in this world thinking that we need these animals and that they're here to serve us, when actually they're not here for us, they're here with us. And it's important that we get that, guys. So just a little rant and rave there, and then to let you know, I'm doing absolutely fantastic, guys. I've got a lot of things I want to be achieving, and my health is getting so much better. I'm feeling so much stronger in my gym work as well. Like I say, you've got to look after yourself to be the best advocate you possibly can be for the animals. And that's just one thing it's really kicked in lately. I just want to get myself better. Like I say, I've missed so much in life. And like I say, people say to me, how do you give up the exercise and do it the right way? Well, it's just as easy as this. You just commit to doing it. Like I say, I know it's really, really hard. I had exercise bulimia, but I've now used my exercise to get muscle on, to get myself healthier. And if you're doing it for the right reasons, then you'll always be doing it, you'll always be getting healthy. So you've got to look at it, it's like anything, it's a trained behaviour. If you can rewire your brain, because that's exactly what's going on here, it's become a habit. And it's just like anything, when you're in calorie deficit, your brain obviously tells you that you obviously need to migrate. So it's like you're in the olden days, if you can think it, when we were back in the cave days and our ancestors, they'd be migrating looking for food. That's what your brain's telling you that it's actually needing. So you start exercising a lot because it doesn't know where its next meal's coming from, it's looking for food. So the important thing to do is obviously make sure you're fueling your body constantly, because even a little bit of restriction, your body's going to hold on to that. And your body's very, very smart, your brain's very, very smart. If it feels that you're not going to give it the next meal, it's going to do everything it can to store that. So you've got to fuel your body, get yourself better. Yes, it is possible. Yes, you can do it, and yes, you will do it. So if I can help you in any way, guys, about anything, please let me know in the comments below. I love you so much. And remember, as always, binge on life, purge negativity and starve guilty feelings, and be kind to every kind. The only difference is your perception. And remember, as like I always little say, all you beautiful souls, and spreading compassion in the tofu cube of truth all around the world. Speak to you soon. Binge on life, purge negativity and starve guilty feelings. Speak to you all soon, and love you so much.